Night SmackDown.
You didn't believe, did you?
After years of frustration, the world's strongest man has become WWE's most destructive champion.
Mark Henry is world champion.
I'd like to welcome all of you to the Hall of Fame.
Now, Mark Henry's path of destruction leads him straight to the Viper. Randy Orton challenges Mark Henry for the World Heavyweight Championship. And this battle is going to hell.
Sadistic.
Misery and agony.
Inhumane.
The world's strongest champion. The WWE's greatest predator. Hell in a Cell. WWE Hell in a Cell.
Why is the only superstar who hasn't competed inside Hell in a Cell? WWE.com's clear choice to win the structure's first ever triple threat match for the WWE title. Check out our exclusive analysis to find out why WWE Champion John Cena and CM Punk are both at a surprising disadvantage inside the Devil's Playground this Sunday, only on WWE.com.
And we welcome everyone back to Friday Night SmackDown. I'd like to take this opportunity right now to put you on the spot. You've been very vocal about our COO, Triple H, losing control of WWE.
Here's all I have to say about this. The company's in chaos. The COO, Triple H, isn't even here tonight.
I just want to assure all of you that I am in complete control of both Raw and SmackDown in the WWE. I will always do what is right for the WWE. I don't care if you have been here for 10 years.
Excuse me!
Hunter, Mr. COO.
I don't want the new you. The new you sucks. I want the old you.
You know that there's a conspiracy against me.
Once again, you're not gonna do the right thing.
What kind of man are you?
Things have gone from bad to worse now that Triple H is in charge.
You can't separate personal issues from business issues.
Triple H, perhaps, as COO, has lost total control of the WWE.
You know, it seems to me that you don't quite get it, do you?
Maybe I just need to be the bigger man, you know? Maybe I just need to swallow my pride, do a better job.
I think you're a poor excuse for COO.
Maybe you're not the guy for the job.
I'm trying my ass off to be the man.
What are you gonna do about it?
Triple H has lost.
Wife's the one who runs the show around here anyway, right?
Why don't you do the WWE a favor and resign?
Has lost total control.
You're fired, and I am gonna kick your skinny, fat ass.
The fine you each $250,000 apiece.
It's not Hunter. I'm your boss. Ms. Truth, you're fired. To every WWE superstar in the back, I want you to hear me clearly.
Triple H.
No one
has lost total control.
Is bigger than the WWE.
And ladies and gentlemen, going to be interesting to see how Triple H handles one of the most chaotic nights of the year, Sunday, at Hell in a Cell.
Listen
up, okay? I totally understand your frustration, okay? Believe it or not, I'm as frustrated as you guys are. I've been trying to get in to see Triple H since Tuesday, but he hasn't been available. As Executive Vice President of Talent Relations, it's not making me look that good, okay? The bottom line is, I understand and hear what you say, okay? And I'm still a company guy.
First of all, John, I want to thank you for allowing me to exercise my legal expertise. Now, we've all talked, and I put something together that I think will help assuage everyone's concerns.
You know, another thing is, I think everybody knows my history with legal counsel, and I'm pretty comfortable here with David. I mean, he has a Juris Doctorate from Harvard, and I'm quite sure he can handle all our grievances.
So we're all in for Monday then?
Yeah, let's do it.
Monday's
right.
Now calm down, guys. This is a true company man here. We'll get it done.
Well, come on, guys. Let's get to work. Okay?
Let's do it.
Let's get started.
All right, guys.
We're back on SmackDown in St. Louis. There is the Gateway Arch, designed to last 1,000 years, reaches 630 feet in the air. And, of course, St. Louis, the hometown of Randy Orton, who meets Christian in our main event tonight on our way to Hell in a Cell.
1,000 years. When was it built? 1963. You're a loser.
Following Divas Master Schedule 4-1 fall, making her way to the ring from Jacksonville, Florida, in the WWE Divas Champion, Killing.
Always great to see the Divas Champion here on SmackDown.
And from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Natalya.
You introduce who's sitting next to you.
Excuse me, Booker. I'm here.
Oh,
hi, Michael.
Hello. How you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. A great win over the Divas Champion on Monday Night Raw. You failed to mention that, Booker. How about that, huh?
I thought Josh was going to get that in.
Well, that wasn't tag team competition as we see here. It will be one-on-one this Sunday in New Orleans. Do you feel you can get it done?
Do I feel? I know I can get it done. Kelly has not proven anything. She's had a couple of fluke victories, big deal.
You know, that sounds like confidence, but it could be overconfidence the way I see it.
Not a chance, Booker.
And Beth, you understand I'm a huge supporter of yours, but you did mention on WWE.com how upset you were over the fact that Kelly defeated you in your hometown of Buffalo at Night of Champions in front of your family.
Oh, why did you see that? I'm sorry, go right ahead.
Booker, can I speak?
My
can
man,
I get a
I just got a little excited
out?
Right there. Kelly is doing the job right now and doing it like it's supposed to be done. I'm sorry, but go ahead.
And right there you see Natalya getting the job done.
Whoa, you're right.
Beth, let me ask you, though, you don't feel that you and Natalya have underestimated Kelly's ability?
You know what, Josh? It's those kind of comments that really make me mad. Everybody's saying that we're jealous. Michael, you understand what we're up.
Of course I do.
You understand our point of view.
Of course I understand it.
Beth, you and Natalya often refer to yourselves as pin-up strong on Twitter. What exactly does that mean?
Pin-up strong is basically the perfect combination of beauty, brains, and brawn, and that's what you get with myself and Natalya, and that's why I'm going to be the next Divas Champion. There's no doubt in my mind at Hell in a Cell.
You don't feel that Kelly possesses those traits?
Kelly is lacking in all of those traits, and the WWE Universe, they're sadly mistaken when they choose her over us.
She's the
Divas Champion, Natalya,
exactly my point right there. Kelly just pulled it off.
That's Phoenix from behind.
And now Beth with the glam slam on the Divas Champion.
You know, Beth and Natalya just got too much pent-up frustration. They just need to just let it all out.
Oh, no. We saw Natalya use this Monday Night on Raw. Just a nasty submission maneuver.
You gotta be kidding me.
Did you hear that? Wait.
Shh. Come on, guys.
Oh, Kelly. That's exactly the sound that you're all going to hear this Sunday when I take the Divas Championship from this undeserving, screaming little Barbie doll.
Those are the actions that you agree with, Cole. Those are the antics that you find okay.
I believe that the Cinderella's title reign is over 48 hours.
That was totally uncalled for, man.
As we mentioned, Hell in a Cell 2 days before Sheamus faces Christian at Hell in a Cell. The Great White challenges Cody Rhodes for the Intercontinental Championship. It happens next.
Friday Night SmackDown, Jim Ross and Taz at ringside, and Taz, look who's here.
This contest set for one fall is for the Divas Championship. Introducing first from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, she is the current Divas Champion, Maryse.
You know, Jim, I had a conversation earlier today with Maryse.
Of course you did.
And I'm happy to see she took my suggestion on not wearing a full jacket, just wear the sleeves.
Ah, I also, now you're a fashion consultant.
Yeah, I am. I also got her on an abdominal.